Welcome to online learning. Today's activity is going to look very familiar because it's a bit like yesterday's. So what are we doing today? Well, you're going to be picking one of the eight interests from your student and family survey that's going to be your interest for studying an organization for the next few weeks. Now, the websites I have listed for you are not the ones that you have to stay with for the next few weeks, but they're there to help you tune in to how we're going to start researching for an organization that we choose later on. So you should recall that you have a student interest survey where you picked your top three interests, and then you talk to your family about their top three interests. You're going to find an interest that overlaps or that your family has talked to you about that they support, and maybe it's an interest you already have, which is perfect, and that is going to be the one that you choose next to it. So you'll notice we have environment, animals, medical services, fair job, education, bullying, elderly, and food and supplies. So these are the interests. You and your family discuss them, and whichever one you decide today will be what you end up finding an organization to tie to. Now, for today though, you're going to use one of the websites that's already linked to this interest to practice tuning in to what you need to research. We've already practiced this once, so it should feel very easy. It should feel easier to navigate, but some things get laid out a little different, so just be careful. We're going to practice this again with pause just to really emphasize about our purpose and our goal. We need to quote it from the website. I don't want to summarize it. I need to use their words because mission statements, purposes, goals, aims are super important to an organization. It dictates, it tells everyone else what they're doing, and I need to quote them. You'll notice Concordian has a mission statement and it hangs right at the front of the school. As soon as you walk in, it is there on the wall in very big letters. It's that important that we quote it. So I'm going to go to my PAWS website. I'm going to write the name exactly as it appears at the top. I'm not going to call it a charity organization. I'm just going to say the name and I would put it here. The website URL is something I would copy just from the top. I copy, I paste, and if I'm finding it again here because I haven't gone to another website, perfect. And then I would say if it's a local or global organization, and I want to be specific as to what city its headquarters are in. I'm going to put head Q. And then I want to be specific about if it's helping only in that city or helps all over. So helps in Bangkok. So I'll be specific. Now I want to find their purpose, their goal, their mission, their aim, whatever synonym they use, I want to find that. So I found it in the About section here, but I'm going to click on the About tab. I'll let it load and I'll scroll down to find out for the About. And I have to kind of skim and scan and I'll click See More. Now the first part, created by former, this is giving history. I don't need that part for the mission, but their purpose is written here. It's very clear. So I copy, I paste, and I'm at a stopping point. Now for the logo of the organization, I could screenshot it, but maybe this one came out very blurry. So I can go to Google and I would say PAWS Bangkok. I'm going to be very specific and type logo and go to images. And I'm going to look for the one that is on the website. You'll see there's a bunch of different things here for PAWS. And I want to click on this one. Now this is another website. This is Twitter. So I'm going to copy this image, paste it in, and then in my source section, I'm going to have to say that I got it from Twitter. So I'm just going to add a little space right here, and I'm going to say twitter.com. I want to go ahead and click on this because it'll take me to the website. Ah, and it's their PAWS Bangkok. So I'll just copy and paste. That's a little faster, and it'll be accurate. Now I'm at a stopping point. So just to emphasize again, copy and paste the mission statement. It needs to be very clear that it's their words, not yours. It's not a summary. And you're going to pick one of your interests. So the number one that your family can support. And then you'll practice this with the website using the same form as you did before. If you have any questions, please ask your teacher.